Hello everyone. Here is a video showing an Allen 301B traditional AGO console opened up so that you could service anything you need to service in the unlikely event that Allen needs any major service. As you can see, it is a very well constructed instrument and everything is on hinges for easy access. Here we have the swell keyboard hinged up so that you could also take two screws out and hinge up the great keyboard. I don't have that one in the up position at the moment, but it's easy enough to do. And as you can see, this has the Allen patented wooden key stick keyboards with plastic covers on the ends, of course. But plastic is a very nice feeling plastic, and they are great feeling keyboards to play. They're not tracker touch, but they feel really nice. And up here, you can see the back of the stop rail showing all the little stop action magnets, because this has a moving capture system where when you press the pistons, the stops actually move to tell you what you have set on said piston. As you can see, it's a model 301B, serial number 47223, and Allen headquarters tells me they manufactured it in 1980. This is a beautiful console and easy to work on should it ever need it. Here I'll give you some close-ups of the various inner workings of it. Over here is an S50 Allen amplifier. That one is only for the pedal and bass channel. That goes to a separate HC12 speaker, the output of that does. Over here you can see the left-hand cheek block with the transposer and the voicing control. And when you change the transposer to anything but neutral, the red light comes on to tell you you're not in the key you think you are. And here you can see the contacts of the great keyboard. And as you can see, starting at this end, there are single contacts, and when you get to the middle portion of the keyboard, there are two sets of contacts. That is because this organ has a separate analog Celeste tone generator independent of the computer generated voices, so that your Celeste stops are warm analog sounding and very beautiful. And they combine with the digital stops absolutely wonderfully. And as you can see, they are what they call self-wiping contacts. They actually clean themselves a bit as they're played. So this doesn't generally need contact cleaning on a regular basis, as long as it's played reasonably often. Over here in the right hand side cheek block, you can see the back side of the card reader under there, and also you can just make out the back side of the Alesis Nano Verb. I installed that into the cheek block right under the card reader so that it's easy to control when you're seated at the playing position, because the Nano Verb has lots of options. And it's not, well, for a lot of times it is a set and forget situation for the reverb, But if you would want to play with it, it's there to play with it and customize it for different things. Here you can kind of see on the back side of the Nano Verb, the two gold items are Harrison Laboratory expression pedal isolators on the output of the Nano Verb. Those are put in on these computer digital Allens so that the expression pedal works correctly with the Nano Verb installed. Because although it looks almost like a factory installation, it did not come as a factory option on this organ. So here we'll hinge down the manual, the swell manual, and here you can see the tops of the wooden key sticks and the swell contacts and so on. And as I said, they're very nice feeling keyboards to play. And now I'm going to hinge down the stop rail. As you can see, everything on this organ is on hinges. Everything necessary to be on hinges is, so that things can be opened up, looked at, and adjusted rather easily. And now we'll go around to the back side and show you some of the guts of it from the back. We'll start over here on the right hand side. You can see up in there the lamps for the card reader. I have the instrument on now, and the lamps are all working, and the card reader works just fine. Here you can see the DM memory capture action backup power supply unit. It's a little transformer with four D-cell NiCad rechargeable batteries. When I got the organ, I needed to replace all four of the batteries because they were 30 years old. And batteries at 30 years don't hold their charge very well. So I got four new ones and soldered them in, and now the combination action works perfect. Here you can see the computer board that controls the memory. It's the memory for the combination action. And it's a fairly good sized board, and like I said, it works just fine. Below that is the power supply for the capture memory that powers all the stop action magnets, so that when you press a piston, it has the juice to change any of them or all of them at the same time. This is a dual memory. It has two memory slots, and one is key lockable should you want to do that. And this is not the old sequential action where they go in groups. This will do them all at once, or two at once, or however. And next to that, you see the S100 100 watt Allen amplifier. This one is for the main channel. And next to that, you see the power distribution block for the various amplifiers and power supplies. And next to that, another S100 amplifier. This one is for the flute and bass channel. And next to that, you see the power supply to turn on and off the delayed power, because it turns on the computers first, and then after that it turns on the amplifiers, so you don't get pops through the speakers as you're turning the instrument on and off. Below that, or next to that, is the regulated power supply for the various operating voltages of the computer section and the voice generating boards. And it is also the power supply for the lights in the card reader. And you can see that you can adjust the the voltage of the lights. Right now I have them adjusted to 8 volts, which is standard, and the card reader works just fine. And going up here, you can see the S50 amplifier for the bass flute channel. And here's some computer cards. This one is the keyboard array card that tells the computer which keys you're pressing. And here is the main tone generating board. It's MOS-1 technology, metal oxide semiconductor, or silicon, depending on who you talk to. And this one board here is the complete tone generating system of the organ, except for the Celeste generators. Now that is mounted on a hinged panel that just hinges right open to get to the rest of the guts. As I said, Allen makes these things very classy and easy to work on, should that ever be necessary. Here's more computer cards. One is a tremulant board, and one is the random motion generator. Below that is a stop board array, and right above that is the digital to analog converter. It takes the digital signals and converts them to audio signals and sends them on their way to various things. And here you can see the analog tone generating board in it for the analog Celeste section. A very beautiful sound, and it mixes well with the digital sounds as well. Here you can see the crescendo and swell pedal, and as you can see, they're constructed of heavy duty cast aluminum. Like everything Allen builds, it's very quality, heavy duty, and high class. There's the roller for the contacts for the crescendo pedal. As you move the pedal, the roller moves, and that angled contact makes contact with the various wires there to turn on the stops in order. And here you can see the audio routing of the audio cables. I have a splitter in there so that the bass and flute channel go both to the crossover for the pedal channel amplifier, and also you get some of the pedal and flute channel bass through the main flute amplifier. Whereas if you would just use the crossover, then everything bass would only go there, and you would get no bass at all through the main flute channel. I kind of like it this way, and I did that on advice from my friend John, who says that's the best way to set these up, and I believe it because it sounds good. Over there you can see the crossover. There's the backside of the stop action magnets and the backside of the manuals. You can see the nice heavy duty hinges they're put on. You can see the neat and tidy wiring that Allen does. Very high class instrument all the way around. From a service point of view, they are easy to get into, and everything is laid out in a very nice, orderly, and intuitive pattern. Down here you can see the three antiphonal speaker relays, because although I only have three speakers on it right now, it does have controls on the stop rail that you can turn the mains off and turn the antiphonals on, or turn them both on at the same time should you wish to use more speakers with it for bigger space. And the S100 amps will drive two speakers a channel with no problem. So there is an Allen organ all opened up for you to see what makes one of these tick. and there's a lot of stuff in it, but like I said, well organized, well crafted, and very high class workmanship. Thank you for watching.